Hello, my name is Warren Loken, and I'm the Director of Data and Analytics at Augustine Surgical. Augustine Surgical specializes in solutions designed to make surgery safer. Our main product is the HotDog Temperature Management System, a novel air-free patient warming technology that can improve patient outcomes and workflow efficiency compared to other solutions. But not only that, it also reduces costs. And that's the subject of this video, comparing costs between forced air warming solutions in the marketplace and the air-free hot dog patient warming system. Before we get started, one primary difference is that forced air warming solutions are disposable. On the other hand, the hot dog patient warming system is reusable and requires either a capital expenditure or participation in the hot dog partnership program. With capital, the price tag may at first glance seem high, but hot dog will prove to be much less expensive in the long run. In the case your organization would prefer not to allocate capital to warming, Augustine Surgical also offers a partnership program that allows you to pay for patient warming with a low monthly fee from the operating budget. Let me show you how you should be warming all of your patients for much less than you are currently spending. The following analysis is based on the national average of 2.6 surgeries per day per operating room. So the cost per use for forced air warming is straightforward. The average sales price is anywhere between $6.50 and $20, depending on the style, make, model, and contracted pricing. For this comparison, we will use a relatively low average sales price of $8, which is less than many of you are spending. In addition, passive warming with cotton blankets is usually used to supplement forced air blankets. For this comparison, we'll use a low estimate of two cotton blankets at $2.16. So the total cost for forced air warming per patient will be $10.16. In contrast, the hot dog system is reusable, utilizing a high-tech semiconductive fabric to warm above and below the patient. Because it is reusable, the cost per patient needs to be calculated based on the amortized cost of the products over the useful life. The controller lasts for 10 years, but we use 5 years for the calculations. Blankets and mattresses last for 2 years. So if we look at the hot dog annual capital allocation, it's roughly $2,300 per year. So let's examine and compare forced air warming costs of $10.16 per patient with hot dog. And when we take the 663 patients and divide them by the $2,300, we get to $3.45 per patient. That's a savings per patient of $6.71, or 66%. Annualized, forced air warming is $6,736 in comparison to $2,289 for hot dog. Again, the savings are significant, approximating $4,447 in 1 year. If we look at the break-even point, forced air warming, the monthly spend is $561. The two-year spend is $13,472. For a hot dog, the capital allocation paid is $6,857. So if you look at the break-even point between forced air warming and hot dog, you'll see it's at 13 months, from which point you're well ahead with hot dog. So in closing, with hot dog, savings are significant, a whopping 66% based on the capital model and 50% on that partnership program model. The overall savings by switching to hot dog are significantly greater than simply reducing the per patient case costs. Hot dog offers an air-free solution, can lower operating costs, reduce supply inventory and reordering, increase warming productivity and capacity, and reduce waste and energy usage. On top of that, hot dog patients have safer and better outcomes. For example, hypothermic outcomes post-surgery are reduced by 22.7%. In this case, we should all agree you get what you pay for and more with hot dog. Hot dog patient warming, the only way to warm. Thank you.